Dear students, welcome to Tungala online classes. In the last video, we were discussing the general characteristic features of bryophytes. Now, in this video, we'll start with the classification of these bryophytes. Okay? Classification of bryophytes. So these bryophytes are mainly classified into three categories. So those are, first one is liverworts, hepaticopsida it is called as, and second one is bryopsida or musae it is called as, and third one is enthoceratopsida. But in NCRT, so only two categories have been mentioned over here. So first one is hepaticopsida liverworts, and second one is bryopsida or moss plants musae, right? So one by one, let's discuss now. Classification of bryophytes. Here bryophytes are classified into mainly three categories. And first one is hepaticopsida. They are common known as liverworts, and second one is bryopsida. These are known as musae, or these are also known as moss plants, and third one is enthoceratopsida so is another one, right? Hepaticopsida, bryopsida, enthoceratopsida are the three categories that we come across in the classification of these bryophytes. So first one is hepaticopsida. These are commonly known as liverworts. Two examples or three examples we can mention in this one. So first one is Marchantia, and second one is Rickettsia, and third one is Porella. So these are the best examples for this one. And moss plants, we can take Fineria and Polytrichum. Fineria, Polytrichum are the best example for this one. And here example for this one is Enthoceros. So here Enthoceros, so this group of plants is not included in NCRT. That's why I leave this one. These two will study one by one. These are the examples, remember. Okay, so first one hepaticopsida. So these are commonly known as liverworts, right? Hepatocytes, the common name. Liver, you might know, liver is one of the organs in our body. Okay, so how the liver is, it is highly lobed one. So the plant body of these liverworts is also lobed one, hence it is named as, so hepaticopsida or so hepaticae or liverworts, these are commonly known as, right? Whenever you see the diagram of Marchantia as well as Rickettsia, so their body is lobed. Already we have seen the diagram of Marchantia in the previous video. So let us see here, this is how the plant body is. So in the same way, you can observe here, these are nothing but a tubular what? Rhizoids. So this is the plant body, right? How the plant body is? So it is just like the lobes of liver. Hence, these are commonly known as liverworts. Okay, so now let us discuss the occurrence of these plants. So as you know, these plants are growing in wet soil. They are growing in wet soil as well as dampy places, right, on the barks of trees, on the barks of the trees during rainy season, even sometimes on the walls these plants are growing. Even some of these liverworts are growing on rocks itself. So if a little bit of soil is there on the rock, so they initiate the life there on the rock, right? So like this, they grow on even rocks. So this is the occurrence of these liverworts. And second one, next one is plant body. How is the plant body? Already I have explained the plant body of Margansia. Taking an example of Margansia, I have explained. Once again, we will see the same thing. How is the plant body? It is highly lobed. It is highly lobed dorsoventrally flattened, right? So dorsoventrally flattened thallus, this one, along with this one, dichotomously branched plant body it is. Dichotomously branched plant body it is, right? So like this plant body is, and here the thallus is differentiated into what I have already mentioned, root like stem like and leaf like structures. It is differentiated into root like stem like as well as leaf like structures. Okay, so here root like structures are called as what these root like structures are called as? Rhizoids. What these are known as? Rhizoids. What are the functions of these rhizoids? You know the functions of rhizoids. So they help in two functions. What are the two functions of rhizoids? One is the absorption of water and minerals. Absorption of water and minerals. And second one is anchorage. Anchorage is nothing but fixing the plant body into the soil, right? So that is why these rhizoids would help in these plants. This is the major function of these one. These rhizoids are simple tubular structures. These are simple tubular structures, not a branched one, right? Multicellular one. So these are simple tubular structures in these kind of plants. Okay, so this is about the plant body. This is about the plant body. And the same plant has one unique feature. What is the unique feature I had mentioned in the previous class? Try to remember yourself. What is that? So they do not have any conducting tissues. So these plants are said to be as non-vascular plants. Why these are called as non-vascular plants? Why? Because these do not have vascular tissues. These do not have any vascular tissues. What are the vascular tissues? One is xylem as well as phloem. Both are absent over here. These two are absent in these plants, hence these are non-vascular one. But still, there is one strand of parenchymal cells that helps in conduction of water as well as food in these plants, especially higher plants of bryophytes, right? So, okay. So, this is the plant body, how it is. Next characteristic feature is reproduction. These plants especially reproduce by three methods: vegetative type of reproduction, asexual type of reproduction, as well as what? Sexual type of reproduction. Among these three, sexual type of reproduction is very important to know. Okay, so first one is vegetative type of reproduction, and second one is asexual type of reproduction, and third one is sexual type of reproduction. These are the three kinds of reproductions that we have already gone through. So, in general characteristic features, once again we'll revise the same thing. First one is vegetative type of reproduction that occurs by fragmentation. Okay, a fragment of the plant body which detaches from the parent plant, so grow into new individual. This is fragmentation. And once again, tubers are also formed over here, and adventitious branches are formed over here. So, all these are vegetative type of reproduction already I have gone through. And next one is asexual type of reproduction is very important to know over here. So, asexual reproduction that take place by sporulation. By sporulation means sporulation usually take place in a sporophytic plant. Where does it take place? In sporophytic plant, sporulation occurs means the process of formation of spores that take place in sporophytic plant which is diploid in nature. Already I have explained this one. Okay, so in sporophytic plant, so this is the condition. So these spores are formed over here. So when they come out of the sporangium, right? So here one thing we should be very clear about this asexual type of reproduction which is seen in sporophytic plant. See here, in sporophytic plant we'll come across three major parts. So I shall take the example of Funaria, mosses. In mosses I am going to explain it very thoroughly. So but still I will give one hint over here in this part. Sporophytic plant, so since it is not dominant one, it is a recessive one, it is depending on the gametophytic plant for its nutrition, right? So this sporophytic plant has three parts that we come across. Number one, foot. Number two, seta. Okay, and capsule. So these are the three parts that we come across in this sporophytic plant. Okay, it's very clear. Foot is the basal part which helps in attachment of this sporophytic plant on gametophytic plant. Foot, seta is there as well as capsule is there. When I draw the diagram of Funaria, that moment you will come to know. Sometimes these bryophytes which are growing so along the ground, some of the examples like Markansia, Rickettsia, some others are prostrate and they are erect in nature and they grow right angles to the ground as if other plants itself. So Funaria or the mosses are the best examples for that one. Okay, so I will explain this sporulation method in mosses thoroughly. Okay, so these are the three parts, especially capsule part. This capsule acts as what? Sporangium. It acts as what? Sporangium, which contains many number of spores. Okay, this sporangium mainly consisting of spores. These spores are, when these spores, they fall on the substratum. When they fall on the substratum, they grow into new individual. New individual. This is how asexual type of reproduction that occurs in what? That occurs in these plants, okay? By sporulation method. And one more is very important one, gemmule formation. What is that? Gemmule formation. Sorry, gemmae formation. Already I have explained what these gemmae are. So see here, on the midrib part, there is no actually midrib part, so looks like that. So okay, so on that, on the dorsal side of the plant body, this is the dorsal side of the plant body, this is ventral side. Ventral side, what are present over here? Hair like projection, that is nothing but, so rhizoids are present over here which encourage the plant body, right? So on the dorsal side you will find a cup shaped structure, and that cup shaped structure is called as Gemma cup. What it is known as? Gemma cup. And that Gemma cup, which contains multicellular green asexual buds. What this Gemma cup contains? This Gemma cup contains multicellular greenish, multicellular green asexual buds called as what? Gemmae. What they are known as? Gemmae. And these gemmae, when they come out of the plant body, yes, they grow into new individual. This is also one more asexual type of reproduction that occurs in these hepaticopsida, that is liverworts. Okay, so this is about what? This is about vegetative type of reproduction as well as asexual type of reproduction. And last one is a very important one, that is sexual type of reproduction. In sexual type of reproduction, usually formation and fusion of male and female gametes, they take place. So let us see here, sexual type of reproduction in which usually you will find the archegonium as well as antheridium, the sex organs. Okay. Yes, now you are observing here male plant as well as female plant. Okay. So if the sex organs are present on the same plant, then they are described as what? What they are described as? Monoecious. Okay. You know, monoecious plants, right? And dioecious plants. Monoecious plants, both of themselves are confusing us many a times. Monoecious plants, these are bisexual one. So dioecious means unisexual one, right? Bisexual and unisexual. So the best examples I have already mentioned related with these monoecious as well as dioecious already in the previous class only. Okay, let it be monoecious plant, dioecious plant. We consider here dioecious plant. So this is male plant which produces male sex organ. Male sex organ, what is male sex organ? Antheridium. Okay, as well as so archegonium, female sex organ which is produced on a so female plant. Okay, so this is the fact which is known to us. So both these antheridium as well as this archegonium are jacketed themselves, means they are uncovered over here. So hence they are said to be as jacketed sex organs, already I have mentioned. Okay, so now how the sexual reproduction that occurs, let us discuss now. So what happens here in male sex organ? So there is a stalked receptacle that you come across, special structure that you come across. That sex organ itself is antheridium, and the stalk of the antheridium itself is called as what? Antheridiophore. And what is the stalk of the archegonium called as? Archegoniophore. Right, so on that stalk like structure, so there the male and female sex organs would be there. They will be in clusters, umbrella like structure that you find here. So right, so from that umbrella like structure, one is so opened on, that is so antheridium structure it is. And this antheridium mainly consisting of androcytes or the male sperms, and these androcytes, so they come out of this what? Androcium, right? Antheridium. When they come out of this antheridium, so they start to swim themselves. Why? Because these are forming what? Biflagellated sperms, right? Flagellated sperms it produces, and those sperms swim in water. As you know, a thin film of water is required for these plants for sexual reproduction. So these antherozoites, what I have written over here, they come towards what? Archegonium through water medium. Okay, so archegonium, whenever you take the longitudinal section, that moment it is a flask shaped structure which has three major parts. One is a stalk, venter as well as neck, right? So stalk, let it be, venter as well as neck are playing very important. See here, so biflagellated gamete, if it came over here, so that moment what happens, these two cover cells, they degenerate themselves. When they degenerate themselves, so they come, actually a question arises, how do these male gametes come towards the archegonium only, sir? So the question arises, that is by chemotactic way, right? What is this chemotactic, right? Chemo means chemical, tactic or tropism. Tropic means towards the chemical which is released by these archegonium. So these antherozoites, they come and they enter through this neck. As you are observing here, neck canal cells, these neck canal cells start to degenerate themselves. So when they start to degenerate, ultimately this gamete that comes towards the venter canal cell, venter cell, and the venter cell also degenerate, and ultimately what happens here, fusion of male and female gametes that take place. See here, whenever the male and female gametes, they fuse each other, it forms what? Zygote. What it forms? Zygote. So let us see, this zygote is a single celled structure, right? And this zygote which undergo what? Mitosis. It undergo mitosis so as to form what? It forms ultimately the embryo. Hence these plants are called as embryophytes, embryo bearing plants. These are embryo, and this embryo which grows into new individual, and that new individual is what kind of plant it is? You know, this is gametophytic plant, what we are learning over here. These are gamete producing plants. Ultimately gametes fuse together what? Zygote. Zygote grows into what? Embryo. Embryo grows into what? New individual. And that new individual is a sporophytic plant. What kind of plant it is? Sporophytic plant. So alternation of generation has taken place over here. Gametophytic plant which grows into later So sporophytic, and sporophytic produces what? Spores. Spores grow into what? New individual, that is gametophytic plant. This is how alternation of generation that occurs in these plants, right? So this is the explanation about liverworts, right? Next one is mosses. Okay, moss plants, mucci or bryopsida, it is called as. The best examples for this one is Fineria, Polytrichum, right, and Sphagnum. So these are the best examples for these mucci. Okay, so here these plants are also occurrence. So in shady places, and moist soil, right? On such kind of substratum, usually these kind of plants are growing. So this is quite natural one. And what is the difference? So these are somewhat advanced than that of the previous one. These are growing upright. Growing upright means right angles to the ground. They are growing right angles to the ground. Okay, so the best example for this one is Fineria, right? Fineria. So I shall draw the diagram of Fineria, right? So here this is the structure which produces what? Rhizoids. On this one you will find some of the leaves. On this one you will find this kind of sporophytic plant. Okay. So this is how the Fineria is. Fineria, in this part you will find what? So these are rhizoids. So here you will find two major parts in this one. What is this? This is a leafy stage or gametophyte plant, and this one is sporophytic plant. Imagine yourself the sporophytic plant which grows on gametophytic plant. So this is a leafy part, this is sporophytic plant. Okay, so this is how the Fineria is, which grows upright to the ground or right angles to the ground. Okay, so this is the fact you came to know, right? The predominant stage, is here gametophytic stage. So here in gametophytic stage we come across two growth stages. One is protonema stage and second one is leafy stage. What we come across? So what is this protonema stage? What is this leafy stage? I'm going to explain now. Okay, so protonema itself is nothing but, it is one of the gametophytic stage, of course, predominant stage, that is gametophytic stage. So this is green, highly branched, photosynthetic plant, right? So but it does not produce any leaf like structures over here. So this kind of highly branched highly branched protonema stage, this one is called as, okay, highly branched one, protonema stage it is. It grows into later, so next gametophytic plant. Of course, this stage itself is called as what? Protonema stage. It is green and highly branched photosynthetic plant, of course, right? So which grows later into leafy stage, and ultimately on that leafy stage you will find what? The sporophytic plant. So this is protonema, right? And leafy stage, how it is? See, you can observe here itself, okay, this is leafy stage, what we call it as, means it generates what? It produces leaves, right? So that is very important one. And after this protonema, there you come across the secondary protonema. The concept of a secondary protonema is very important. So what is this secondary protonema? The question arises. Here, secondary protonema, usually any undamaged cell of leafy stage, right, or any protonema stage, right, the part of this protonema means undamaged cell or the tissue of this protonema or the leaves, right, leafy stage. So any one of the part of this plant which detaches from the parent plant and it grows into, so what? Secondary protonema. Secondary protonema itself is one unique feature that we must remember over here. So this is secondary protonema, the concept. How the reproduction that occurs in these plants is very important one. So you know, so reproduction, reproduction occurs by vegetative method, that is a fragmentation, right? It is quite natural one. And one more important thing is budding also taking place over here. What take place? Budding also take place over here. So where the buds are formed, here at the axis, there some buds are produced over here. So these buds which detach from this parent plant due to decaying of the tissue between this bud as well as the parent plant, it detaches and grows into new individual plant. So budding is also seen in these one, right? That is also one more. And second one is asexual type of reproduction. So let's come to the main important point. What is that important point? Asexual reproduction over here. So here you will find the sporophytic plant which produces what? Spores. What it produces? Spores it produces. These spores, where they are actually present. So here in the sporophytic plant, already I had mentioned, there you come across three major parts. One is called as foot and seta and capsule. These three parts that we come across. See here, this part itself is called as the basal part on the leafy stage, that is foot. And this is called as what? Slender seta. And this part itself is called as what? Capsule. Capsule is uncovered with what? It is uncovered with calyptra. Calyptra. And inside this capsule, you will find many number of what? Spores within it. What are present over here? Right? Spore mother cells will be there. And these spore mother cells undergo meiotic division, and ultimately they form what? Spores. What they form? Spores. When this calyptra that detaches from this capsule, these spores, they come out and they settle on one of the substratum. When they settle on the substratum, they grow into new individual, and that individual is nothing but protonemastage. That individual is nothing but protonemastage, and this protonemastage later grows into adult leafy stage, right? So this is how alternation of generation that occurs over here. So what are the major parts? Food, seta, as well as capsule. Capsule has a covering cord as calyptra, right? So calyptra, when it detaches, all these four mother cells, so they undergo meiotic division and produce what? Spores. Spores come out and so they settle on the substratum, and later new individuals are formed. That new individual is gametophytic plant, that is previously what it is? It is protonemastage. Protonemastage it is, right? And later it grows into leafy stage. Okay, this is how asexual type of reproduction that occurs over here. And in the leafy stage, since it is gametophytic plant, so in the leafy stage, on the upper side, you will find some of the what? The sex organs. So what are the sex organs? Are antheridium as well as archegonium. So branches are there, special branches which produce antheridium as well as archegonium. So they produce respectively antherozoites as well as archegonium is female sex organ, right? So where both the gametes fuse themselves through water medium, and new individual that is formed, and the new individual which is formed is sporophytic plant. This is how sexual reproduction that occurs in these plants. Okay, so this is all about the classification of these bryophytes. Thank you.